Collaboration by Philip Blundell and Andrew J. Holland, 2021. This collaboration is a COVID remote dialogue via email. Images are sent to and fro like a game of ping pong. Each image received may provoke a response related to the received image, or may draw a blank, in which case a new idea could be introduced into the sequence. The proposal came from a Derek Bauchier artwork I saw in the Whitworth Art Gallery in Manchester, which consisted of a large series of postcard-sized photographs exhibited in a long line on the gallery wall, which created a visual story. Our presentation shows the interchange of two people. The conversation brought up some interesting ideas and also allowed us to know a little more about each other.
out.
She's been taken away, and it's revealed these posts, these pillars, these stones, sandstone pillars. Because you get a feel of it, you get a feel of the thing.
Yeah.
And then when you do another one, you're copying yourself rather than copying a photo.
Ah, okay.
Which is only two dimensional.
Oh no. Just because it went off.
Well, I don't know how.
Second-hand items.
At last it seems we have been set free, but I still love to gaze at my favourite tree. My coffee is brewing away in its pot, I'm sat by the window, it's lovely and hot. Birds in the trees playing, having fun, my neighbour is sat all alone in the sun. I think to myself, where is his wife? She's usually right there by his side. Their garden is always tidy and lovely, flowers, bushes and trees make it homely. But seeing him there, he looks rather lonely. People arrive, but he doesn't look happy. They're up on ladders, trimming his hedge. He's pacing around, hands clenched, looking tense. He's up and down from his chair, clearing their mess, and doesn't look happy with his much shorter hedge. 7 years I've lived here, and not a word spoken. But watching him now, he looks a little bit broken. He also looks a little bit thinner, hedge trimmed. Thank goodness it's time for his dinner. It looks like the people are actually family. Well, they're eating lunch under the canopy. No laughter or smiles or easygoing chatter. He's sat in the corner like he doesn't matter. As I move from the window to get on with my day, I make a mental note to give him a wave. He's all alone now. He has to be brave.
The sun pours forth. Energy descends. Light giver, caretaker, tapping gently on all threads of life. The ancestors are a hungry collective. The wild garden is not tended with gentle hands. They forgetteth wisdom and consume to satisfy their god. Technology. Trees fall, silence creeps into the wild places. The ground shivers and doesn't understand. Colossal hives are constructed. The village becomes a town. The town, a city. Cities connect and sprawl washes over the land. Earth reacts, iridescent waves, pummels steel walls, relentless tides of rust. Metal spray and crumbling foam. The sounds of slow cracking echo through chill skies. Many words for snow vanish from memory. Tropical seas boil and splinter. A spectrum of colour collapsing. As Gaia rages, the ancestors seek for dark recesses, havens of solitude from the tempest. They gather together for warmth and slowly remember who they are. Deep networks of being soothe and sustain. The collective holds itself close and familiar. It hears the rage and hurt, and it understands. The old ways fade. Unhealthy scraps and petty words. The ancestors peer out curiously. With one vital eye, darkness, void. Eye focuses and understands. From within and without, expanding stars, celestial chaos, constant change, all things flex, shifting, melting, waxing, waning. From within, strange new forms coalesce. A being of light descends. The darkness embraces the light. The two dimensions swim as one. Celebration. Brilliance. Radiant energy. The ancestors know beyond knowledge and hold beyond touch. Life grows as one. A billion stars pour forth, energy abounds. Light giver, caressing the dark. We are caretakers, tapping gently on all threads of life.